Hey, what's up? My name is Daniel. Thanks so much for joining me today. NF just released a new song. I think it was last week at some point. And so I'm super excited. NF's never let me down. I don't really like rap or hip hop that much, to be honest with you, but I really love NF. Like, he hasn't let me down this far. So I'm excited. Let's listen to his new song. Here we go.
Hope. I'm on my way. I'm coming. Don't lose faith in me. I know you've been waiting. I know you've been praying for my soul. Oh, oh. Years you've been dragging your feet, telling me I'm the reason we're stagnant.
It's like Castaway.
30 years you've been claiming your honesty and promising progress. Well, where is it at? I don't want you to feel like a failure. I know this hurts, but I gave you your chance to deliver. Now it's my turn. Don't get me wrong.
Nature had a great ride,
but it's time to
give the people something different.
So without further ado, I like to introduce my album. Hope. What's my definition of success? Listening to what your heart says. Standing up for what you know is right while everybody else is. Taking their toe between their legs. What's my definition of success? Creating something no one else can. Being brave enough to dream big. Grinding when you're told to just quit. Giving more when you got nothing left. It's a person that'll take a chance on something they were talking never happened. It's a person that can see the bright side through the dark times when there ain't one. It's when someone who ain't never had nothing ain't afraid to walk away from more profit because they'd rather do something that they really love and take the pay cut. It's a person that would never waver or change who they are just to try and gain some credibility so they can feel accepted by a stranger. It's a person that can take the failures in their life and turn them into motivation. It's believing in yourself when no one else does. It's amazing what a little bit of faith can do. If you don't even believe in you, why would you think or expect anybody else that's around you to? I done did things that I regret. I done said things I can't take back. Was a lost soul at a crossroad who had no hope, but I changed that. I spent years of my life holding on to things I never should have kept, full of hatred. Years of my life carrying a lot of baggage that I should have walked away from. Years of my life wishing I was someone different, looking for some validation. Years of my life trying to fill a void pretending I was in. They get it. Evil, difficult to go through, yes, but beneficial. Some would say having a mental breakdown is a negative thing, which on one hand I agree, but on the other hand it was the push I needed to get help and start the healing process. See, if I'd have never hit rock bottom, would I be the person that I am today? I don't believe so. I'm a prime example of what happens when you choose to not accept defeat and face your demons. Took me 30 years to realize that if you want to get the opportunity to be the greatest version of yourself, sometimes you gotta be someone you're not to hear the voice of reason. Having kids will make you really take a step back and look in the mirror. At least for me, that's what it did. Every day and pick my son up, hold him in my arms and let him know he's loved. Love. Standing by the window questioning if that is ever going to show up. Up isn't something he's gonna have to worry about. Don't get it twisted, that was in a shot. Mama, I forgive you, I just don't want him to grow up thinking that he'll never be enough. 30 years of running, 30 years of searching, 30 years of hurting, 30 years of pain, 30 years of fearful, 30 years of anger, 30 years of empty, 30 years of shame, 30 years of broken, 30 years of anguish, 30 years of hopeless, 30 years of hey, 30 years of never, 30 years of maybe, 30 years of later, 30 years of fate, 30 years of hollow, 30 years of sorrow, 30 years of darkness, 30 years of 30 years of baggage, 30 years of sadness, 30 years of stagnant, 30 years of change, 30 years of patience, 30
years of pain, 30 years of bitter, 30 years of lonely, 30 years of pushing everyone away.
You'll never revolve.
I know I can change.
We are not enough.
We are not the same.
You don't have the heart.
You don't have the strength.
You don't have the will.
You don't have the faith.
You'll never be loved. You'll never be saved. Might as well give up.
Not running away.
You don't have the guts.
You're the one afraid.
I'm the one in charge.
I'm taking the.
No.
I'm taking the.
Reigns.
Wow. Wow. That was so good. Okay. I feel like it's not as good for people who don't watch or listen to NF, because I could see the threads of previous songs and videos like tying into that. So in all of his other videos, he's wearing all black and he is carrying around these black balloons. And it's just kind of this cloud of like depression and anxiety and like that, this kind of way, it has this like dark weighing feeling. And he's, most of the time in the songs, he's talking about his struggles with those things. But then in this video, he's wearing all white. That was the first thing I noticed. I don't know if he meant to reference Castaway or not, but it looked a lot like Castaway, like when Tom Hanks was on the raft leaving the island. Only what was interesting is he was coming to the island, and the island actually looked similar. It's obviously not the same island, but it looked a little bit similar to the one that was on Castaway. Like when he first pulled up, I was like, is he like making a reference? But I don't think he was. Anyway, that's beside the point. But in this one, he's wearing all white and he's like looking, he's what's the word I'm looking for? It's like he's confronting the previous version of him, or it's like, this is going to sound kind of dark, but it almost feels like he's arguing with some kind of demon who is trying to convince him that he is not enough. And like, biblically speaking, this is what demons do. They get in your ear. They tell you God doesn't love you. They tell you that you're worthless. They tell you not to chase what God put in your heart, to do for his glory. They beat you down. They weigh you down. And it's like it feels like this song is him saying that he had some kind of breakthrough where he's like finally realizing the truth. And at the end, it seemed like it was kind of creepy, but it was really cool. Cause it was like it ended with him, not the, like, for lack of a better term, the demon. It ended with him saying, I'm taking the reins. Like, I'm taking control back of my life and I'm not listening to you anymore. And that's just super refreshing, because listening to Nate, I've always kind of like felt bad for him, like, because his lyrics are so good. You can tell the struggles that he's going through. Like, you can just kind of feel this darkness that weighs on him. And here he's saying things like, in one of his previous songs was about how his mom kind of treated him poorly, but the point is he was holding on to things against his mom. And here he's saying, I forgive you, mom. Like, he said that line in the song, and he's wearing all white. It's like he had some kind of breakthrough and he's like taking control back. But man, that was really good. I'm going to have to go listen to that again and really listen to the lyrics. Thanks so much for tuning in. I'll see you next time.